theme for this year's Commencement Ceremony is Pressing for Excellence. Our scripture will come from Philippians chapter 3, verses 13 and 14, and it reads as follows: Brethren, do not count myself to have apprehended, but one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forward to those things which are ahead. I press towards the goal, the prize of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus. Let us bow in the prayer. All wise and eternal Father, we thank you, Lord God. We thank you for this opportunity, Lord God. We thank you for another commencement, Lord God, in the name of Jesus. We thank you for all your provisions that you have provided for a successful completion of another year through virtual learning, through the virtual learning experience, Lord God. This great institution, Lord God, we ask that you continue to bless and keep her, Lord God, as she continues to teach the word of God. We ask that you continue to bless and keep PBICS, all of the faculty, administration, and students, as well as the whole church, Lord God, and Pastor Dr. Askins. We wish all of our students, Lord God, on each level, Lord God, blessings in their ministry, Lord God, and as they go forward, Lord God, to do the work that you have prepared for them to do, Lord God. We ask you to guide us, Lord God, guide administration, Lord God, and guide the faculty as we begin to prepare for another year of study, Lord God, at PBICS, Lord God. And we ask, Lord God, that you bless, Lord God, the students, Lord God, the returning students, Lord God, and the new students as well. Again, we are grateful for all that you've done and all that you're going to do, Lord God, now and in the future. Continue to touch, Lord God. We will continue to preach and teach your word, Lord God. That your will be done. Your kingdom come. In the name of Jesus, I pray. Amen.
Good morning. Hallelujah. This is our great God in the world. We welcome you in the name of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. Today we welcome you to our 2021 graduation and commencement service for the Philadelphia Bible Institute College and Seminary. Today we are here to celebrate this great school, faculty, and every student who studied to show themselves approved unto God, workmen that need of not to be ashamed, rightly dividing the word of truth. I speak on behalf of the students. Together we praise our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ and the Holy Spirit for allowing us to excel to another spiritual sphere, to be equipped and successful in the work of ministry. So again, we would like to welcome and thank you once again for joining the 20 and 21 graduating class, and we pray that you enjoy the graduation and commencement services of the Philadelphia Bible Institute College and Seminary. God bless you, and may heaven smile upon you. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amazing grace shall always be my song of praise. For it was grace that brought my liberty. Amazing grace shall always be
Through this commissioning, God birthed Doxa Ministries, Church Without Walls. With the vision and obedience, we go as ambassadors for Christ with the word of reconciliation. Since 1998, Pastor Tony has overseen a work which takes the gospel of Jesus Christ to the streets of Baltimore City and to the world. In the early years of Doxa Ministries, Dr. Murray also served as an associate minister to Pastor Harris Drumming at the Rainbow Family Christian Center in Silver Spring, Maryland. He was blessed to be a vocalist with Psalm 150 and an evangelistic band during that time. Pastor Tony earned 2 years certificate in theology at the International Harvest Bible Training Center in Owings Mills, Maryland. He also completed the course of study at the GLAAD, God's Law Against Drunkenness and Drugs Institute of Nuthetic Counseling, and was certified as a substance abuse counselor. In 1999, Reverend Tony began teaching at the Philadelphia Bible College Seminary and Institute here in Baltimore, Maryland, and was awarded his doctorate in theology from the school in 2004. He is currently serving at the Philadelphia Bible Institute College and Seminary as instructor, director of student affairs, and also a member on the board of directors. We just thank you so much because we have the pleasure, we have the privilege, and the opportunity to introduce one of God's choice preachers. Amen. He is the pastor of Doxa Ministries, which is a worship center at 2520 Pennsylvania Avenue in Baltimore, Maryland. Is there, he is the senior pastor. He has also traveled to international places on numerous occasions for the purpose of preaching and teaching the gospel of Jesus Christ, and also training leaders in those countries. He also served as an overseer to the Pilot's House Pastoral Leadership Training Center in Nigeria since 2007. Pastor Tony and his wife have been blessed to have 5 children and 8 grandchildren, to God be the glory. It is now my pleasure to introduce and to present to some of you Dr. J. Anthony Tony Murray, Senior Pastor of the Doxa Ministry, Church Without Walls. Hear ye him.
Good morning. I bring you greetings in the name of Jesus Christ, and I want to give honor to God for all the good things he has done. I also want to greet our President and CEO, Dr. Milton Perry. I want to greet our Vice President, Dr. Warren Jones, and the Chairman of our Board, Dr. Robert Franks, as well as all the board members, all the anointed and appointed faculty members, and of course, our youth students, who are the reason for our being here, that we might do those things to enable God to give you those things, be prepared for you at this time in your walk with Him. I'm excited to be here on this morning, on the morning of your commencement, having finished this school year, and being thankful to God that He has brought us all through. This is a great time of Thanksgiving. It's a time of recognition of the goodness of our Lord, because it has indeed been a challenging year, but I thank God that He enabled us to persevere and to get through those things we needed to do to be successful. Let me read from the Bible, from Philippians chapter 3, verses 13 and 14. Brethren, I do not count myself to have taken possession, but one thing I do, forgetting the things behind and reaching forward to the things before, I press to the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. Paul said that he was pressing to the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. And like Paul, we should all be pressing for excellence. That indeed is our theme this year for this convention, pressing for excellence. You know, we just completed a year of education at Philadelphia Bible Institute College and Seminary. We've lived through a challenging year due to the coronavirus pandemic. Many of us have dealt with family issues. Many of us have dealt with health issues. Many of us have dealt with employment issues. It indeed has been a challenging year. But have you given any thought to what has kept us all going? Have you given any thought to why we didn't just throw up our hands and give up because things have gotten to be so difficult? Was it a personal commitment that you had made to yourself to get through this year and complete the work that you needed to do? Was it some kind of desire on the inside to improve yourself or maybe improve your position in the church? Was it a desire to please somebody other than yourself? A spouse, a child, a parent, a mentor? Or was it just that you wanted to prove to yourself that you could do it? I hope none of these things were what was driving you. I hope that it was your faith in the God that made you and the God that leads you that kept you going in spite of everything that challenged you. There is a faith that we have in Christ Jesus that is more, much more, than pressing to make it through this life. It's much more than piling up achievements in this life. It's much more important even than knowing why we're doing what we're doing. It's knowing what we're doing for the God we serve. Turn with me to Jeremiah 29 if you have the Bible. And let's look at what God said to us through that prophet. Jeremiah chapter 29, verse 11. For I know the thoughts that I think toward you, saith the Lord. Thoughts of peace and not of evil, to give you an expected end. God has good thoughts toward you, that you would have the end he's prepared for you. That's the expected end God is talking about. And that expected end will bring you a place of excellence. When you're pressing for excellence, you're pressing for Jesus. You're pressing to be in that place that God has called you. It's a high calling, yes, but it's a calling that God has guaranteed you will achieve if you just stay with him. If you just trust in him, you will reach that expected end knowing that he has good thoughts toward you. We have a God that cares about every aspect of your living, but most of all, he cares about the promises that he's made to you. And he has promised you an expected end. He has promised you that he'll be with you until you reach that end. So you have to trust him. You got to believe in him. And this will allow you to keep going with him no matter what things face you along the way. Let's go back to the book of Philippians. We'll read some more what God had Paul write. Chapter 1. I'm going to read verse 6. Being confident of this very thing, that he which hath begun a good work in you will perform it until the day of Jesus Christ. Paul says that God has begun a good work in you. That's because God's work can only be good. If God is doing work, it's going to be a good work. And you've got to believe that. Now, God's work can only produce God's will. God's work will never produce something that is contrary to his will. So if he's begun a good work in you, he is working his will in you to will what he wants you to do. God wants to do this work in you because he has an expected end for you. And this work is his method of bringing you to that expected end and bringing him glory in your life as you go along the way. You are pressing for excellence. because it's something that you decided to do, but it's something that God ordained for you before he formed you in your mother's womb. And you got to believe that. You were not here at Philadelphia because you decided to go to Bible college. You are here at Philadelphia because this is something that God planned for you along the way to the place he's taking you as you press for excellence. And you got to believe that. This will keep you going. This will put you in a place where you never want to give up, because you know you will be contrary to the work that God has begun in you, the good work that he's doing in you, and will prevent you from getting to the good place that he has prepared for you in your expected end. Look at, let's look at one, add another scripture here. Turn to Ephesians. Book of Ephesians. One turn to the left in your Bible. Chapter 2. Verse 10. For we are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works, which God hath before ordained that we should walk in them. We are his workmanship. He's the potter. We are the clay. God is doing the work. God is doing the good work. We are his workmanship, created in Christ Jesus unto good works. These good works were preordained that we should walk in them. In other words, God already had your to-do list laid out before he even made you. He's got things that he intends you to do, for you to do in this life on your way to that expected end. And we need to be excited about the work that God has given us to do. But we should not confuse the good works that God preordained for us with the good work that God has begun in us and will complete in us until the coming of the day of Jesus Christ. You see, our good works demonstrate that his good work is taking place in us. You know, Apostle James wrote, you show me your faith and I'll show you. You show me your work and I'll show you my faith by my work. In other words, our good works are coming because of the faith we have in our good God. Amen. So you got to remember that, yeah, we are doing good work. Coming to Philadelphia Bible and studying to show yourself approved is a good work. But it is not the good work that God is doing in you. You getting your degree today or your certificate today is a good work. But it is not the good work that God is performing in you, that he has promised to complete in you until the day of Jesus Christ. Your degree is not the prize that God is calling you to in his high calling that is upon your life. And your degree is certainly not the good work that God is doing in you, though it is the good work that God ordained for you to do to his glory. So let's not be confused about which works we're dealing with. Let's look at another scripture. Going back to Philippians, chapter 3. I'm going to start reading in verse 8. Yea, doubtless, and I count all things but loss for the excellency of the knowledge of Christ Jesus, my Lord, for whom I have suffered the loss of all things, and do count them but dung, that I may win Christ, and be found in him, not having mine own righteousness, which is of the law, but that which is through the faith of Christ, the righteousness which is of God by faith, that I may know him, and the power of his resurrection, and the fellowship of his suffering, being made conformable unto his death, if by any means I might attain unto the resurrection of the dead. Not as though I had already attained, either were already perfect, but I follow after, if that I may apprehend that for which also I am apprehended of Christ Jesus. Paul said, I want to know him. Paul said, I want to know the power of his resurrection. Paul said, I want to be found in him. Paul said, I know that I haven't attained, but I was looking forward to getting there. See, Paul said earlier, he was pressing to the prize of the mark, the high calling of God. And you have a high calling of God upon your life that you should be pressing to. And that should be to know Christ. That should be to know the power of his resurrection. That should be to be found in him. That should to be to realize that you're not perfect, but you're going to be perfect because God has made you a promise. He said that you are a son of God. In 1 John chapter 3, verse 2, he said, "Beloved, now we are sons of God, and it does not yet appear what we shall be, but we know that when he shall appear, we shall be like him, for we shall see him as he is." That is the high calling of God, that we will be like him. That is the excellence to which we are pressing, that we will be like him. All of the other things you do, if they be the good works that God preordained you should do, are to give him glory and are to work toward the spread of his kingdom in the earth through evangelism, through prayer, through fellowship, through sharpening, through correction and rebuke. But it is not the prize. The prize is Jesus and only Jesus. And God has called us all to be like Jesus. So let's continue to press toward that which is excellent. Don't stop pressing no matter what gets in your way. Romans 8, verse 29 says, "For whom he did foreknow, he also did predestinate to be conformed to the image of his Son, that he might be the firstborn among many brethren." Verse 30, "Moreover, whom he did predestinate, them he also called. And whom he called, them he also justified. And whom he justified, them he also glorified." Listen, there is glory in your future. You got to know that. We should be thankful for today, but we should be looking to the future. And know that God is with us all along the way. We should be diligent in doing that which God has for us today. But we should never lose sight of what God has for us tomorrow. That high call that is placed upon us will be fulfilled when we see Jesus face to face, when he's returned to his rightful place. When he sits upon the throne of David and rules and reigns forever and ever. Yes, it's excellence. And yes, it's the place you're called to. I congratulate you all on what you've accomplished to this point in your lives through Christ Jesus. And I want you to understand that you can't do it without him. You're not getting these grades on your own. You're not finishing these assignments on your own. You're not even showing up every week on Mondays and Tuesday nights on your own. But it's the grace of God that is ushering you unto that expected end that he's prepared for you. But along the way, give him all the glory and give him all the praise. Along the way, be thankful unto him, for he is your Father who cares for you, so much so that he sent his Son to die for you, to open a way for you to be called to be like him. I don't know about you, but I want to be like Jesus. I don't know about you, but I'm going to keep on pressing. I don't know about you, but I'm going to give my all to giving him all, because he is my all. And he will never leave me, and he will never forsake me. He will never let me fall, but he will direct my path as I lean on him and not my own understanding. I don't know when that day is going to come. But I do know that God has a plan. And in his plan, all of his sons will be prepared, will be perfected, will be completed unto the image of his Son, Jesus Christ, on the same day. And what a glorious day that's going to be. Nobody but God can work that out. To bring all the lives of all of these souls together at one time and finish the good work that he began in each and every one of them at the appointed time on that great and terrible day of the Lord. Listen, I want you to be happy about what you've done. But be like Paul too and recognize that all we do here in the earth pale in comparison to what God has prepared for us in glory with him forever. I bless you today. May God continue to keep you today. Those who have finished and gotten through your doctoral program, God bless you. Go forth and do great and mighty things. And all those who have ended their tenure here at Philadelphia Bible Institute College and Seminary, go forth and do great and mighty things by the preparation that God is affording you. And those that are coming back next year, come back with enthusiasm, come back with expectation, but come back with confidence, knowing that this is something God has called you to do, and he will not let you fail. When I say this to you and to all that are listening to my voice, be like Paul. Be sold out to what God is doing in you and the place to which God is calling you. Don't count yourself as having already taken possession, but forget whatever is behind. Reach forward to the things that are before and press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus. God bless you all. Let us pray. Father, we thank you for this glorious day. We thank you for the success that you've afforded these students. We thank you for the call that you have upon the lives of them and the faculty and the leadership and their families that support them. But we thank you most of all for Jesus the Christ. And we thank you for calling us and for promising us that you will get us to the place where we shall be like him. In his name I pray. Amen. God bless you.
Good afternoon. Praise God for whom all blessings flow. We honor the Lord and the power of his presence always among his people. We thank God for giving us this great, grand, and glorious day. We thank the Lord for our President, Dr. Mildred Aaron, Vice President, Dr. Warren Jones, staff, and the entire faculty. We praise God for this student body graduating class of year 2021. We know that there have been many challenges throughout the year. We are still yet within this pandemic. Many ups and downs, trials, and tribulations, but nevertheless, you persevered. Some of you were sick, some of you had surgery, some lost loved ones all throughout the year, but we praise God for your steadfastness. And I want to certainly congratulate you along with the faculty and commend you for a job well done. I do want to say to the remaining students, returning students rather, to make up in your mind today that you are going to come back and further your Christian education and growth in this great institution of learning. And to those who have graduated, doctoral students, you are now officially members of the alumni. And we want to encourage you as well to stay connected to the school and do whatever you desire the Lord placed upon your heart to do and help this great learning institution to succeed, to excel in the things of God. So again, congratulations. God bless you. May heaven smile upon you.
We have that certificate award for the highest grade point average for the first year. Certificate of Excellence is hereby granted to Felicia Montague, highest grade point average, first year institute level in the 2020-2021 school year. Amen. For our second year, if we have a single student this year, and that student receives the highest grade point average for this school year, 2020-21, and that person is the name of Melvin Martin. Congratulations to you all. this time, we want to announce the certificate of excellence in 2020 as for achieving the highest grade for our lives.
attention to all of our campuses today. And we thank the Lord for the 2020-2021 school year. We thank the Philadelphia Christian Church and Ministry for hosting us today. And we thank Bishop Clarence Askins as the pastor of the Philadelphia Christian Church and Ministry. As we close today, we want each of you to remember our theme, the class of 2021, pressing for excellence, from Philippians 3, verses 13 to 14 of the New King James Version. It says, brethren, I do not count myself to have apprehended, but one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forward to those things which are ahead, I press toward the goal of the prize of the upward call of God in Christ Jesus. To those who are pastors, we hope we take that thing to our churches to make more disciples. To those who are lay people and are not pastors, take this thing to the church in order to help your pastor, in order to help your fellow primaries, to be more committed to sight and to press for excellence in the Lord Jesus Christ. It is our desire that we can make disciples for Christ. It is our desire that in making disciples, we glorify God in all things. So, from this point forward, we are all pressing for excellence and be blessed.
Praise the Lord, saints. Truly, we preach in the name of our great God and Savior, that's none other than the Lord Jesus Christ. Just an encouraging word for the doctoral students and reminding them of the alumni. And so this is a charge to Philadelphia Bible Institute College of Seminary alumni. The Philadelphia Bible Institute College and Seminary alumni are important to the longevity of PBICS. It is our hope that after a student graduates from PBICS, they will stay connected, loyal, and supportive to our foundational mission. PBICS' mission is to equip and train students to go into the world and make more disciples for Christ. It is exciting and encouraging to see how the alumni of PBICS are ministering in our local communities, our cities, our state, potentially impacting our nation and the entire world. PBICS is thankful and proud of the commitment of the alumni to continue to support the future of their alumni by helping current students reach their educational goals through financial gifts and participation in PBICS events. It is vital for PBICS family to stay connected, thereby strengthening our bonds and effectiveness in serving Jesus Christ. We ask that our alumni keep their contact information where they are serving in ministry currently. We would never want you to lose sight or to break fellowship with the college to which you have graduated from. We encourage each one of you to take serious this application and participation in the alumni and see if you can also come back and teach. Amen. We pray God's will for you, and we pray God's blessing on you. Let us pray then. Eternal God, Father, we thank you for your goodness.
We ask now, Father God, that you might stir the hearts of these students, Father God, of their sincere remembrance and be part of the great work. It is in Jesus Christ we pray, and our hearts all say, amen. God bless you.